Hi, and welcome to Out of the Darkroom on Adorama TV. I'm here in the National Portrait Gallery in London for the Taylor Wessing Photographic Portrait Prize. Behind me, you'll see a piece by Graeme Robertson, who is an amazing photojournalist that works for some of the country's top newspapers. He's going to be joining me on the show today, and we're going to be discussing everything that he shoots, from musicians to politicians, wars to World Cups.
Adorama TV presents Out of the Darkroom with Ruth Medjber.
Hi Graeme, thanks so much for inviting us into your home today to have a little chat about your work. I love what you do. You're a photojournalist, but you cover absolutely everything, such a wide variety of work. Was that something that you always wanted to do, or how did you end up in photography?
Well, I do cover a lot of different things.
A lot of different things. Everything I can think of, you covered it.
I think that when I was younger, I always wanted to sort of specialise.
Yeah.
And I realised that if I sort of specialise in something, it's much harder to perhaps get an opportunity. Mm. So I tried my hardest to sort of try and do as many things as I could, really. And when I became an apprentice photographer, I was doing everything. I was doing football, yeah. PR work, news events, features, and I really liked doing something different every day.
Because, I mean, like, you're in The Guardian now, which is probably the most prestigious role in the UK for a photojournalist. I know you trained as you were a darkroom assistant, but do you have any, like, other qualifications that would have landed it, or was it just on the basis that your work was amazing, they were like, yeah, we'll give you the job?
I've got pretty much no qualifications. Okay. I went to university and went to college when I was very young, but then I'd done an apprenticeship. I think my training was really, really good. I worked as a darkroom assistant, which was a fantastic experience because I was just looking at photographs all the time,
yeah.
Which made me a really good editor.
Great, yeah. And
then when I got an apprenticeship up in Dundee in Scotland,
yeah.
The photographer was on the sort of broadsheet sort of side. He was very creative. He had really good rules put in place. He was very strict with me. He taught me the proper way to deal with situations. He taught me really well.
What's the proper way to deal? What kind of, like, you know, when you, is it when you arrive on location and meeting someone?
Yeah, just the process. He taught me how to have a process, how to gauge my subjects, how to make sure I cover a job properly, not to get too excited, and to have certain things to do on every job. And he gave me a formula. And then after that formula, I could be creative. Because if sometimes the creative stuff might not work, but if you do a creative thing and it doesn't work, then you've got nothing.
Yeah, so you have a fallback of safe options.
So you have some
options.
Sort of a safe part and a creative part and this, that.
Yeah.
And it really taught me well.
The Guardian, I suppose, send you out on so many different assignments. They've given you lots of opportunities. Is there anything in particular that you've loved? Any one project? Because, I mean, you cover everything. You cover musicians and politicians and, you know, the portrait side of thing. I mean, is there anything maybe in your work along the way that you favoured, that you'd always angle towards? Or,
you know, I do enjoy everything.
Yeah, okay.
I think that the past I was... I did a lot of reportage kind of abroad, wars and famines and you know, lots of civil wars or real conflict
Absolute
stuff.
Conflict.
And I slightly got disillusioned by that.
How so in that, like?
I don't know. I felt that a lot of people were getting into that because they thought that if people took photographs of pain and suffering, then that would be good photography. And I disagree.
Yeah.
I disagree that just because you take pictures of somebody firing a gun or getting killed, that would be a good photograph. I don't agree with that. When I joined The Guardian, I knew that my role would change.
Mm.
I knew that, one, they didn't have the sort of huge budgets to go and send a photographer away for 6 months to cover
this,
to cover that. I knew that my work would change. But
yeah.
So when I started doing portraits and stuff, I really got interested in the control.
Yeah.
You know, the control that I had.
Yeah.
If in news photography, if it doesn't work, you can make your own luck. You know, there's nothing like, you know, you can't be a lucky photographer. You need to research it and be in the right position to make your own luck, you know. If a photographer walks into a room and shows that they're not in control, then that person won't, you've lost that, sort of portrait, you know?
So it's confidence.
It's confidence. You know, there's been situations that the PR have said, you've got 1 minute.
Yeah.
And I've not even picked my cameras up and sat and chatted for 2 minutes.
Yeah.
And then I've spent the next half an hour photographing him or her. Because you just find that kind of common ground.
And they enjoy it,
and
I suppose.
And then they relax, or they say to the PR, oh, it's all right, well, let's do 10, you know.
Yeah.
So it's a control thing. And what I really, really enjoy about that kind of, that portrait photography is that the control is completely up to me. If I don't get the shot, it's completely my fault.
Tell us then about the equipment that you use to get the shot, whether you've got 1 minute or you've got, you know, a month to plan a shoot. What would you carry around with you? What's your go-to equipment bag?
I shoot in Leicas.
You shoot in Leicas?
I shoot on
I don't think we've had a Leica shooter yet on the show. That's good.
So I shoot on M9s.
Wow, okay.
And I've also got a Hasselblad with digital back, and I've got a Canon 5D Mark III.
Wow, okay, brilliant.
I had this thing that I wanted to slow my sort of reportage-y kind of stuff and sort of enjoy it a little bit more. And the Leica really gave that to me. I used to shoot completely manual cameras back in, you know, when I started, and I loved it. And I sometimes think with the digital, sort of how digital has went, that a lot of people take far too many pictures.
Yeah, just shoot off 100 and hope for the best in one. Like.
And with a rangefinder camera or a Hasselblad, there's just, you can't do that.
Yeah,
so you need to really pick your pictures, make sure that they're correct. You've got that sort of, and that's a beautiful thing for me. And the pictures that are in that project with the blind children, the ones that are in the telewesing, all the portraits, all the reportage stuff that goes along with that is all shot in the Leica. Sometimes when you take a picture of a famous person and you get your Leica out, you would be amazed what they would say. They would say, oh, what kind of camera is that?
And they
say, oh, that's the curious. And they automatically, you have that maybe a different thing to talk about.
I get it.
But I love shooting on the Leica.
So was that a commission? Did someone send you over there, or was it a personal project and you just wanted to go and do it?
The blind?
Yeah.
That's just my stuff, and that's what is really important for me. And The Guardian really, really like that I am doing what they want me to do. Like, they supported this project completely for me. And it wasn't a money-making exercise. It was a personal thing, and it's really important for
me.
It's really important, and it makes me a better photographer, a better person. It makes me, you know, that sort of personal stuff that has a sort of tagline of a sort of story that I can help is really important.
Would you have any advice, I suppose I'm looking for amateurs that are wanting, you know, that maybe have the skills already but just can't break the boundaries into professional to photojournalism?
I think the best bit of advice is not to try and break into it, but just do your own thing.
So just continually keep doing
your own thing. Well, projects is a really good thing. Having a good idea for a project and going and doing that project and fulfilling that project.
Yeah.
If you really enjoy that process,
yeah,
it's like everything. If you enjoy a process, you put everything into it.
Yeah.
And you don't care about if anyone likes it or sees it, or I bet you that if you have that impression, people will love it, and that's how you break into it.
Because
somebody will be like, that's really interesting. See what this guy's spent the last year doing. Or
something.
And then all of a sudden, you know, and you've really enjoyed that, so it's not been a waste of time. Because in photography, in my opinion, in the process, it's like a journey. It's like you're going to drive to France, or you're going to drive to Barcelona, but you hate the drive and you just want to get there.
Yeah.
That's, in my opinion, the journey is part of the adventure. People ask me, well, you know, what was it like living in Baghdad and stuff? Was it really horrible? Was it really bad? And I say, it was wonderful. It was so insightful. And I'm so fortunate to have seen into a lot of people's lives that nobody could even imagine being in these situations. It's a complete privilege that what I do, and what I hopefully will continue to.
I hope so too. I love your work, so I can't wait to see more of it anyway. But listen, thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Thanks so much. A big thank you to the National Portrait Gallery for allowing us access to the Taylor Wessing Photographic Portrait Prize today. Next time you're in London, do pop in and see what they've got on to offer here.
Join me again on Out of the Darkroom when I'm going to be interviewing some more great photographers. Check out the Adorama Learning Centre for some tips and tricks on your own photography. And don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV. See you soon.
Do you want great looking prints at low cost? Be sure to visit our easy to use online printing service. Adorama Pix has professionals who treat your images with the utmost care that you can count on. For a quick turnaround on photos, cards, or albums, use adoramapix.com.